Hello, beautiful people. Welcome to another video. Today, I'm going to talk to you about Lean UX. Have you heard of that term before? So what is Lean UX? I'm going to try and explain it as simple as possible. Hopefully, you understand it. If you've got any questions, by all means, send us an email or drop us a comment, and I'll be sure to reply to you. Before we get into it, I'd really appreciate it if you can give us a thumbs up, a subscribe, and share it with everyone else who might find it beneficial. All right, so Lean UX, what does that actually mean? So to put it in simple terms, Lean UX is really a strategy, and process that marries agile and UX. So to explain very, very briefly, that means you're trying to work on UX practices at a very lean practice. Generally, this is great when you're in a startup environment or when you're bootstrapped, where you don't have a lot of budget and time to spend on UX research or UX principles, basically. What Lean UX does is in an agile manner. Agile does not necessarily mean the agile development, but you're trying to work in an agile manner in a very systematic way that it gives your team the opportunity to design things, test things without having to compromise the quality of the thinking around it. That allows you to move into development with great confidence, knowing that your users will like the features that you're about to launch or the product that you're about to launch. All right, so if I can draw a quick diagram for you, the process goes like this. It goes from think, and if I can just draw a quick light bulb there for you, and then you'd go into design. That's an iMac, if you're wondering what that is. And test, where usually you get user validation against the idea that you're proposing. And the process goes from think to design, from design to test, from test and back to think, depending on circumstances. But if you've been following us, you would see us talking about design sprint a lot. Generally, that's similar to this type of process as well, where you would go from think to design to test and then back to think. Oftentimes the break happens after testing. If you get user validation here at the test state, then you could actually move into production with confidence, and then you could start the next thinking cycle, designing, testing, and then releasing it into production again. So that's really what Lean UX is more or less about. It's being able to, in an agile manner, as I said earlier, work towards getting into a goal where it allows you to use as little resources and time as possible, being able to move forward with a project, being able to launch features, and when it's especially great as well when you don't have a lot of budget, when you're only a startup or a small team, because with larger corporations, they've got resources, a huge team, they've got almost all of the time in the world as well, trying to come up with research, understanding user data and all of that stuff, which are, you know, it's great to have, but it's not the luxury that everyone has. So Lean UX works really, really well when you're trying to speed up certain things, accelerate a project, create innovation and stuff like that, where it's time bound and it's specific to the purpose or the goal that the company or the product is trying to achieve. All right, I'll leave it there. Hopefully that's clear enough. If you've got questions, as I said, just leave us a comment and I'll reply to you. Thank you, guys.